محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، we talked about تفسير سورة البقرة and we saw how بني إسرائيل disobeyed Allah سبحانه وتعالى. All the time Allah سبحانه وتعالى is giving them the best treatment. المن والسلوى. Allah سبحانه وتعالى saved them from the sea and from Fir'aun, and they did immediate disobedience. So يعني I like today to talk about the danger of this disobedience.
Yeah.
I will inshallah mention some examples about the immediate punishment for those who disobey Allah and His Messenger, maybe in dunya or akhirah. There is an ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And let those who oppose the Messenger's commandment beware lest some fitna should befall them or a painful torment be inflicted on them. What does it mean of fitna? فليحذر الذين يعني be aware, be careful, don't disobey Allah سبحانه وتعالى. What will happen if you did this, if you disobey Allah سبحانه وتعالى? Fitna will come to you. What you understand fitna? Maybe the fitna with your iman. If you are a believer, the fitna will come and will affect your iman. Maybe fitna, a war between the Muslim, your country and another country. You don't know, but it can be fitna for your iman. So be aware, don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, alaykum as-salam. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, la tarfa'u aswatakum fawqa sawti nabi, wa la tajharu lahu bil qawli, ka jahri ba'dikum li ba'd, an tahbata a'malukum wa antum la tashurun. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. This is in Surah Al-Hujurat, first ayah, Surah Al-Hujurat, and we talked about tafsir Surah Al-Hujurat maybe 3 years ago. La tarfa'u, don't raise your voice. فوق لا ترفع أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي more than وصف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Maybe you understand only raising your voice. This is not the exact meaning, or maybe this is one of the meaning.
Yeah.
But what if you read this, the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah, then you will understand what happened. A group of people came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muslims or new Muslims. Then Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Umar. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala suggested one man to be يعني their leader, to teach them, to tell them what are the teachings of Islam, how to pray, how to. And Umar رضي الله تعالى suggested another man. So when Abu Bakr said mentioned one name, Umar رضي الله عنه next to him mentioned another name. Then Abu Bakr said, why you mentioned another name? You want to only want to oppose me? Umar said, no, I don't want to oppose. I mentioned my opinion. So they talked in front of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Abu Bakr mentioned one name, Umar suggested another name. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this ayah. So this ayah revealed because of Abu Bakr and Umar. And what they did, if we see this situation, they did nothing. They suggested something for something good for this group. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala considered this, you want to introduce your opinion before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَجَرُ لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُ لِبَعْضِ أَنْ تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالِكُمْ. You will lose all your حسنات وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ and you don't feel. So this is one of the great punishment, and it is also immediate. Because of this sin, okay, you will lose your, all of your حسنات. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an said about following the sunnah, he said, لَسْتُ تَارِكًا شَيْئًا كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَعْمَلُ بِهِ إِلَّا عَمِلْتُ بِهِ وَإِنِّي لَأَخْشَى إِنْ تَرَكْتُ شَيْئًا مِنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ أَزِيغ. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an said, I will not leave anything that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was doing. Exactly what he is doing, I will do. Why? Because I fear that if I lift one thing that he was doing, I will
deviate.
So Abu Bakr said, even one thing, exactly, I will follow Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Abu Bakr knows that if you disobey Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, if you deviate from the sunnah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you. And he will let you to deviate the sirat al-mustaqim. I will mention some examples. The immediate punishment. In Hunayn, you know the Battle of Hunayn, it was in which year? It was after Fatih Makkah, in the 8th year. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Tawbah, وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنٍ إِذَا عَجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ فَلَمْ تُغْنِ عَنْكُمْ شَيْئًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, truly Allah has given you victory on many battles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you victory on many battlefields. In Badr, Al-Ahzab, Fath Makkah, many. And on the day of Hunayn, when you rejoiced at your great number, they said, لَن نُغْلَبَ الْيَوْمُ الْقِلَّةِ. Nobody can defeat us because of our number. So, subhanAllah, of course, not all of them. So, as if they forgot how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the victory when they were one third of the
number. Yeah.
Yes, in Badr, they were one third the kuffar. Their number was 315. 315, and the kuffar?
1,000.
About 1,000, from 900 to 1,000. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the... maybe in all the battles, in all the ghazawat, you were less. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the victory. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and on the day of Hunayn, when you rejoiced at your great number, but it availed you not, and the earth, vast as it is, was straightened for you, then you turned back in flight. Nothing happened because of your number. So because you depend on your number, you do not have the full tawakkul, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished you immediately in Hunayn. Yani if you see the battle of Hunayn, at the beginning, the kuffar won the battle. But alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the end of the battle, يعني, they won the battle. So this is, subhanAllah, immediate. When you say, يعني, of course, and notice, sometimes the punishment will come because of some of the Muslims. Because some of them said, We are strong because of our number. And the same thing. Alaykum salam. In Uhud. Battle of Uhud. The hadith. عن البراء رضي الله تعالى عنه سيد لقينا المشركين يوم أد يعني أحد in the third year البراء رضي الله تعالى said we faced the مشركين and رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم put some of the Muslim army where on the mountain. Why? To protect the Muslim from the back. الرومات who are using the what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, look, يعني, also, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the leader of Ummah. He worships Allah and also he knows the how to lead the battle, how to lead the army. What he said? He said, لا تبرحوا, don't leave your place. Stay on the mountain. Don't leave your place. إن رأيتمونا ظهرنا عليهم فلا تبرحوا. If you see us, we win the battle, don't move. Stay in your place. And also the second option, وَإِن رَأَيْتُمُوهُمْ ظَهَرُوا عَلَيْنَا and if you see the kuffar attacking us, don't help us. This is the importance of the back.
Yeah.
Okay, this is خلاص. This is
direction.
This is the direction from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and also this is for the Muslim army to protect the Muslim army. This is the plan. Don't move. So Subhanallah. At the beginning, what happened? The kuffar ran away. At the beginning, they ran away. Then the Muslim army who are on the mountain saw the ghanima, the booty. And they saw the ladies, also the kuffar, they brought even their ladies, some of their ladies, the kuffar. And they saw the ladies running away. So Subhanallah, the army who are on the mountain came down. But the leader, Abdullah ibn Jubayr radiallahu anhu, said, عهد إلي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا تبرحوا رسول الله I am your leader and رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told us don't move in both options if you see the Muslimin win the battle or if you see the kuffar don't move notice what the narrator said فأبوا what does it mean فأبوا يعني they refused the sunnah. This is sunnah. Sunnah. Okay. They refused. فأبوا. فلما أبوا, when they refused, صرف وجوههم فأصيب 70 قتيلا. Immediately. When they refused, they came down. Khan Walid was mushrik at that time. He came
from back.
And 70 Muslims killed. And of course, this is not a small number. Yes. So Subhanallah, immediate. Just they came down, the kuffar came from the back. Another example in Tabuk. Battle of Tabuk was Ghazwat Tabuk was which year? Before Hajj, in the ninth year. And Tabuk, you know where? North of the Medina. It is far and it was hot. In the way, Rasulullah, and you know, they stay some time to take rest and they move. So one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, سَتَهُبُّ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ رِيحٌ شَدِيدًا. This night, a strong wind will come. فَلَا يَقُمْ فِيهَا أَحَدٌ مِّنْكُمْ. Don't stand up a strong wind will come. Don't stand up. Stay and sit in your place. فَمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ بَعِيرٌ فَلْيَشُدْ عِقَالَهُ. And if you have a camel, if there is a wind, maybe you will say, I will take care about my camel. No. Now, if you have a camel, because not all of them have a camel. Or if you have a camel, from now, tithe. So, subhanAllah, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the strong wind came at night. And this is maybe mu'jiza from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, one of the sahaba stood up. When he stood up, subhanAllah, the wind took him to a place called Bijabalay Tayy. The scholar said this place more than 100 kilos. Alaykum salam. This place, subhanAllah, the wind took him more than 100 kilos. And this hadith in Sahih Muslim. So, subhanAllah, immediate punishment. Because the Rasul, the leader, told you, don't stand up. So immediately, when he stood up, the wind took him. So, subhanAllah, sometimes we see the issue is very small, but it is serious. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw a man eating in front of him and using his left hand, then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded him to eat with his right hand. Why are you using your left hand? Use the right hand. Subhanallah, the man said, I cannot. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, use your right hand. He said, I cannot. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, may you never be able. It was arrogance. Okay? Yani, why he did not use his right hand? Because of kibr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ma mana'ahu illa al-kibr. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, may you never be able. It is a dua. Rasulullah made dua. So subhanAllah, sometimes if somebody refused the sunnah, maybe you can do dua. Subhanallah, what the narrator of this hadith said, and he couldn't ever lift his right hand to his mouth. It got paralyzed. He lost the movement of his right hand. Immediate. Yeah, it was simple. Use your right hand. And subhanAllah, now many Muslims, unfortunately, many Muslims.
Many.
You advise them, use your right hand. I don't know how to use it. You don't know? How you don't know? Even the child can use his right hand, subhanAllah. So we should be like this. We eat by the right hand, with the fork and the knife. Use your right hand. Try your best to use your right hand. Don't use the left. The left hand for the shaitan. If you are shaitan, use your left hand. If you are a Muslim, if you are a believer, if you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, use your right hand. So subhanAllah, this man lost his right hand because of what? Because of eating. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد بينما رجل يمشي في حلة تعجبه نفسه مرجل رأسه يختال بمشيته إذ خسف الله به فهو يتجلجل في الأرض إلى يوم القيامة. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, while a man was walking dressed in clothes admiring himself, his hair combed, walking proudly, when Allah caused the earth to swallow him. Because of what? Kibr. and in the hadith خيلاء يختال. خيلاء is something like كبر. يعني عز الله سبحانه وتعالى say إنك لن تخرق الأرض ولن تبلغ الجبال طولة. If you walk, you will not pierce the earth by your foot, and also you will not be like that
the mountain.
You are a human being. You are nothing. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, خلق السماوات أكبر. The creation of the heavens and earth more than our creation. You are nothing. If you compare, you are nothing. So why when you walk as يعني, in a kibr, proud way? No, you should be humble. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, now he will continue to go down in it until the day of resurrection. Some scholars said, this is Qarun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Qasas, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَا كَانَ لَهُمْ مِنْ فِيَتِينَ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُنْتَصِرِينَ. Yeah, some, Allah alam, maybe Qarun or maybe another one. And also, it can be for anyone who follows this way, the kibr. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Luqman, what Luqman advised his son? وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرْحًا. If you walk, don't walk in a proud way and laughing. Walk in a humble way. متواضع, humble, متواضع. سبحان الله. يعني one of the major sins كبر. If you see many punishment from Allah سبحانه وتعالى because of كبر. يعني the scholars say, and we mentioned this, the first sin was كبر from Iblis. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ. So سبحان الله, this is the head of the sins, كبر. Why? Because what is the definition of كبر? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم gave us the definition. What is the definition? الكبر بطر الحق وغمط الناس. الكبر بطر الحق ترجكت حق. I advise you, please do this and this because of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said this and this. This is the evidence. No, I don't want to follow. Who are you? Who are you? It means to humiliate. غمط الناس. What does it mean غمط الناس? To humiliate others. You see others nothing. So subhanAllah, this is كبر. عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه ان الجمعه دي خطبه الجمعه, what he said ايها الناس انكم تاكلون شجرتين لا اراهما الا خبيثتين. All people, you eat from two trees and I think they are خبيث يعني or bad trees. البصل والثوم, onion and garlic. And I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he finds the smell of garlic or an onion from a man in the masjid, he would take away this man to al-baqi'. Immediate punishment from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If he found the smell, come out to al-baqi. You know al-baqi? Baqi, the maqbara, if you see now.
Yeah.
يعني it is, let's say it is 300 meters from the masjid.
Yeah.
Yes, imagine the masjid, the small masjid, not the whole masjid.
Expanded, yeah.
Yes, it is expanded, but it is about 300. Subhanallah, some scholars said what is the wisdom he put them in the Baqi? Because Baqi graveyard. The masjid is the place for live people, not for dead people. Go to a dead people because of your smell. The live people will get bothered because of your smell. Subhanallah, yani we see this issue is small issue. But imagine, yani, well, we hope that we are strong enough now to ask people to go outside if you find the bad smell.
Yeah.
But if you do this, you will go to the police station and you will be out.
You know, the worst thing is cigarette smell.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Especially Fajr, you know, there's a lot of Kuwaiti have Diwani, they come out from Diwani.
Yes.
Smoke.
Especially in Ramadan. Ramadan and Fajr Salah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Subhanallah. So it is not easy. It is not easy. Because of, and if you think onion and garlic is halal, are halal, both of them halal. But subhanAllah, because of this, don't come to the masjid. So maybe you say, but I love the onion and the garlic. I cannot leave them. So Umar al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an said, فَمَنْ أَكَلَهُمَا فَلْيُمِتْهُمَا طَبْخًا. يعني, if you love them too much, more than your wife, so cook them very well. So by cooking,
the smell will go.
Mm. But maybe you say, but if you cook, we lose the taste. yeah, this is an advice from Umar al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an, that if you want to eat and you don't want to miss the jama'ah, so cook them very well, then you, no bad smell will be there. So these are some of the examples. Maybe I mentioned this is the last example that I have. And there is a book, a nice book about 400 pages, talking about this issue. I took some examples from that book. عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم دخل على أعرابي يعوده. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم came to Arabi, you know, Arabi, Bedouin man. He was sick and Rasulullah visited him. وَكَانَ إِذَا عَادَ مَرِيضًا قَالْ. And the habit of Rasulullah, if he visited a sick man, he says, لَا بَأْس, طَهُور inshallah. Don't worry. Inshallah, it is simple. And it is طَهُور. What is meaning of طَهُور? Purification. Purification, because subhanallah, the disease clears your sin, especially the humma, the fever cleans your sins. So when he entered on that man, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la ba's tahur inshaAllah. He was an old man. Then the man, he was sick and he had fever, high temperature. Then he said, Tahur? Yani purification? He wondered, Tahur? No. He said, Bel, humma tafur, ala shaykhin kabir, tuziru al-qubur. Tahur is not Tahur. It is humma tafur, it is a fever, boiling. Ala shaykhin kabir, it is coming to an old man. Tuziru al-qubur, it makes him
go to the
to visit the maqbara. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yani, I am making dua for you. That's it. Yani, la ba's, yani, inshallah, don't worry. And it is purification. And you refused my dua. This is dua. When you say tahur, inshallah, it is like a dua. So when he refused, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Fana'am idan." Yes, as what you said, not what I said. Because you refused what I said, and you mentioned another thing, then yes for you, for what you said. In another narration, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَمَا إِذَا أَبَيْتَ فَهِيَ كَمَا تَقُولُ. You refuse with my dua, then okay. It is like what you said, not like what I said. وَمَا قَضَى اللَّهُ فَهُوَ كَانَ. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote in the qadr, in the unseen, this will happen. I don't know what will happen in the future. But what you want, خلاص. So subhanallah, فَمَا أَمْسَى مِنَ الْغَدْ إِلَّا مَيِّتَ. Tomorrow morning or tomorrow noon, he died. Immediately, less than 24 hours, because you refused the dua from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's saying okay, and yeah, subhanAllah, this is the sunnah. If you want to visit a sick man, it is good to mention the يعني, nice words, nice sentence. Not يعني some people if يعني for example if we visit a man with a problem with the heart or hypertension, they will mention the bad examples. This man started the hypertension, then after 1 month or 2 months he got another problem in the heart and he died. And this man, they because of diabetes they cut his leg, and they يعني we are experienced mention the bad examples. Okay, mention the good examples. Or if you don't have examples, give him the hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا مَرِدْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. If I am sick, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cure me. This is the rule. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the cure. So subhanallah, these are some examples from the sunnah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish some people immediately because of the sunnah. You did not accept the sunnah. يعني, and we want people to understand understand the sunnah, which is mustahab. What is the meaning of sunnah? Which is recommended to do. No, the sunnah, this is one of the meaning. But the general meaning of the sunnah, anything from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anything from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is sunnah. So, in general, we have to accept everything from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't put in your mind that I will disobey Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is not, from the believers. Maybe we mentioned this point at the time of the Sahaba. They were asking, what is the sunnah? Why they ask?
To follow.
And now why we ask?
To be checked.
To reject. To is it sunnah? Khalas.
To escape.
Okay. Maybe you advise your friend to fast the Monday or the 6 days of Shawwal, or to pray the Duha.
10 days. 10 days.
10 days, 9 days of the Hajjah. What do you say? Is it Sunnah? Yes, Sunnah. Khalas. Sunnah. Okay, what is you advise him to wear something or to eat something, to start an iftar with the rutab or the date? Sunnah? Yes, Sunnah. Khalas. He will start with maybe al-gamat, tashrib. Okay. So subhanallah, we have to ask what is the sunnah to follow, not to disobey. So it is not easy. Yani why I mentioned this topic today, because also one of the examples, Ben Israel, the Yahud. It is a clear famous example, or famous examples. And so you see how in Surah Al-Baqarah, when we mention وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَى لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرًا. What they say to Musa, we will not follow you, we will not believe until we want to see Allah جَهْرًا. Then the immediate punishment, فَخَذَتْكُمْ الصَّاعِقَةً. You know, Sa'iqan from the sky, the light.
Thunder.
Immediately. فَخَذَتْكُمْ الصَّاعِقَةَ وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ. This is immediate punishment. سبحان الله. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ بَعَثْنَاكُمْ بَعْدِ مَوْتِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the life again just to be thankful. And they are keeping, disobeying Musa alayhi salam and also disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the issue is not, it is serious. Now we see many Muslims reject the Sunnah. Even if you talk about the Sunnah, we are not going to practice. No, we are talking about the Sunnah. They will not accept. Alaykum salam wa rahmatullah. There is Sheikh Sayyid.
There's another brother also.
So we want to follow the Sunnah. For example, if you say we want our banks to follow the Sunnah, to reject the riba, you will find some Muslims will say, no, now how you reject riba, now the system of the world, yeah. And this is all to reject the riba. Subhanallah. So only now it is important to put in our minds and our children minds and to inform people, to teach people, following the Sunnah will save your life. It is your life. The Sunnah is your life. If you miss the Sunnah, you miss your life. And remember what Abu Bakr said. I fear if I lift one thing, what is this? Maybe siwak. Maybe the siwak. Maybe the wudu. Alaykum salam. Maybe the way of the wudu. I will deviate. So what do we say? Abu Bakr said this, so what we say? Then we complain. Now we are complaining. Why the Muslim Ummah? Why this is happening in Syria, in Burma, and in Egypt? Why this? Don't say this. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Ali Imran, أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّ هَذَا. We mentioned that. How many killed in Uhud, the battle of Uhud? Because of the people, the army came down from the mountain. How many killed?
70.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ. This is musiba. 70 of you were killed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded, قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا. مِثْلَيْهَا, what is the meaning of مِثْلَيْهَا? Double. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means double? In Badr, what happened in Badr? In Badr battle, the Muslims killed how many from the kuffar?
70.
And how many prisoners?
70.
So مِثْلَيْهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, talking to the Muslims, قُلْتُمْ أَنَّ هَذَا. You say, you are complaining now in Uhud, after Uhud. Why we lost the battle? Why 70 killed? Why 70 Muslims were killed? What is the answer? قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to them, it is because of you. Don't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and don't ask the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because you are the reason. You defeated because of your deeds. Not your deeds, because of some of you, not all of you. And usually who are on the mountain, most of the army or few of them.
You.
So subhanallah, sometimes we got the punishment because of
few.
One, two, three. Don't say this is done. No, this is not done. Don't say this is oppression. No. Because alhamdulillah, who killed will be shaheed. He will be shaheed. And who did not kill, he will learn from this sin. Subhanallah. So now we know we need to correct our working to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to take the whole Sunnah, to take the whole Islam. Don't choose the buffet style. No, follow the whole Sunnah. Then, we need to also teach the Muslims that the victory will come if we follow the Sunnah. This is the rule. This is the rule. No another rule. Don't find another one. Don't find another way. What is the rule? In tansurullah, yansurkum. What does it mean of tansurullah? It means if you support the Quran and Sunnah, if you follow the Quran and Sunnah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the victory. This is the simple rule. It is very, very simple. Now we sit together and we plan how we... It is very simple. Very simple. Don't go right and left and don't go to the kuffar. Come to the Quran. It is with us. The Quran with us. Follow the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the victory and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your heart strong. Will make your iman strong if you follow. Jazakumullah khair wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.